Walking away was the best thing I could ever do. Your shadows darkened everything. Your liquid words had turned to glue. Your beautiful smile once showed me that you were shy, but now your smile is sideways grand. I think it speaks so great. Rain, but it feels like pain is aching in my heart. Never seems to fade. Oh, la-di-da. When you walk in the room and a breeze flows through my hair, but suddenly I can't breathe. You've sucked away the air. Eyes and try to listen to the words you say, but all I hear is thunder. The rumble makes me turn away.
Do it all over again? Okay. What happened? Okay. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Back Talk Teen. I'm Julia here with Kirby, and we have a great show planned for you. And you just heard the very talented Ashley Jordan, and we'll talk to her more later. But first, what did you do on Veterans Day two days ago?
Nothing, really. I think I went on a hike with my dad.
So no school, fun. Right?
No school.
Yeah,
what,
but
what about you?
Well, it was also 11-11-11, and I think some people probably pay a little more attention to the fact that it was a magical day.
Oh,
a
magical.
Lucky day.
Yeah.
So did you make a wish on 11-11 o'clock on 11-11-11?
I missed it.
Me too.
I really, really wanted to because I thought, you know what, I could use a wish, and then, nope, passed me right by.
Exactly. Yeah, I slept through it. I was sleeping until like 11:30, and then... And then I realized when I woke up, oh my god, I missed it. But I had another chance to make a wish because the next day was my birthday.
Oh
so,
yeah, happy birthday.
Thank you. So. I turned 17 yesterday.
Fun.
It was awesome. So I was really determined yesterday to go see an R movie because you have to be 17 to see those, and I'm 17 now. But like with all the birthday festivities and everything and the cake and the presents, by the time we were all done with the whole birthday thing, it was like 9:30 or 10, and so I couldn't go to the movies by then because it was too late.
That stinks.
Yeah, so maybe next weekend, I'm not sure. Yeah, there are
hopefully.
A lot of good movies out, so hopefully we'll all be able to see something. I really wanted to see Paranormal Activity 3.
Oh, yeah, I haven't heard much about that, but that sounds scary.
The other ones?
No, I don't think scary.
They're pretty scary. They made me, like, the ending. You just have to wait for the ending.
Okay.
That is really scary.
Yeah.
Well, on kind of a more random note, we have a visitor in Boston right now, Adele. Well, I think she actually left, but she did have surgery at Mass General for her throat. And it really worries me. She's such a good singer. I don't even want to think about it, but she canceled all of her concerts and her remaining tour. And then people found out that it's because she has these vocal injuries on her vocal cords, and she has to get surgery. And so it was like she would be bleeding from her throat, and that's just, it's terrible.
Ooh, that's rough.
She's such a good singer.
I know, she really is, awesome. But I think they said that it was okay.
Yeah. She's expecting to heal or cover all that, but it just makes me worried, too, as a singer. And obviously, I talk a lot. I'm always worried that something will happen to my voice. But, I mean, I'm no Adele.
Yeah.
I'm not a singer like her. But I think we have a little clip of her.
Yeah, that we can see.
Yeah. Before she got injured.
I heard that you settled down, that you found a girl and you're married now. I heard that your dreams came true. Guess she gave you things I didn't give to you.
That's a really good song.
One of my favorites.
And then, also celebrity news, Eddie Murphy is no longer hosting the Oscars.
What? He's so funny.
I know. The producer, actually, I think it was his own choice to step down, but the producer was Brett Ratner, and he...
They were friends, right?
Yeah, they were really good friends, because he hosted Tower Heist, which was the...
He produced Tower Heist, yeah.
Right, yeah. Oh, yeah. That was, produced it, right?
Movie,
yeah. Anyhow, the new producer, Brian Grazer, is now starting it, and the person that's hosting is Billy Crystal, and he was in When Harry Met Sally, which is a good movie for those of you who've never seen it.
I need to see that. I don't know. I feel like I would have been more likely to watch it if Eddie Murphy was hosting.
Yeah, same.
Because I don't really know this Billy Crystal guy. And you know that when Eddie Murphy is doing something, he's going to deliver. He's going to make it fun.
Yeah, you're right. But now it's like, now we got Billy Crystal.
I'm sure Billy Crystal's a good guy. I don't have those
expectations. He was pretty good in When Harry Met Sally, but it was a little, it was okay.
Yeah, well, speaking of Tower Heist, our very own Josh Englander has a quick little review of it, so let's see that, Josh.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another show of Relentless Reviews. I'm your host, Joshua Englander, and today I'm also going to be reviewing the movie Tower Heist. So can Ben Stiller finally put on a decent acting performance? How is Eddie Murphy? Can director Brett Ratner, who directed X-Men Last Stand, and the Rush Hour trilogy, redeem his rather unpopular reputation? Does the supporting cast do a good job? Can this drama slash action slash comedy heist thriller stand up to other films in the genre? Well, let's check out the trailer.
The average apartment in the tower costs $5.6 million. We have the best views, most advanced security systems, but you know what these people are really buying?
White neighbors?
Us. The staff, they pay for our full and undivided attention 7 days a week.
And Enrique, one other thing. I may have my own private island in Belize, but deep down, I'm just an Astoria boy like Josh here.
That's right, PS-104. Go Lions.
Just an hour ago, the tower's richest resident was released into federal custody under house arrest here at his penthouse apartment.
Several years ago, he was asked to manage all of your pensions. Right now, they're saying that anyone who invested with Mr. Shaw has been defrauded.
Did he get your money, too?
Yeah, he did.
If you need me, I'll be living in this box.
Oh, little seizure boy won't try to rob somebody, huh? What you trying to steal?
$20 million.
A robbery can change very quickly. You have to be ready to adapt to the situation at any moment.
I got your ski hats.
No, masks. I said ski masks.
But the guy said these would keep us the warmest.
Anything can happen. I was on a job a few days ago and my homie got shot in the face.
Get shot in the head, it's over.
If you get shot in your head, it's over. If you get shot in your face, the bullet will go in your cheek, then come out the other side. Then what you gonna do?
Die. I'm gonna die.
First thing you do, you gotta find the entry point. You gotta use your fingers when you find the entry point. You married?
No, I ain't married. What's up?
First of all, Ben Stiller, I'm going to say this right now. I've never been a fan of his acting. But the guy just, this proves it. This performance, he cannot act. He's just not a guy who stands out in a movie as a lead protagonist. Is he the worst actor ever? Is that what I'm saying? No. No. He's not the worst actor. But the guy is just, it's like watching a boring businessman on screen. I feel like he just doesn't ever really bring that sense that you're really watching someone special on the screen. I just hate the guy's acting. I mean, that's just my personal opinion, and you can comment below and tell me otherwise, but I just hate his acting, and I think he's the main lead, so he brings this whole movie down just from his terrible acting performance. Also, the writing. Oh my God, this is one of the worst scripts I've heard this year on film. There's no question about, yes, it is supposed to be a film where you turn off your brain and you just watch some good comedy and some decent action. I understand that. But the writing you can still have decent writing and have it be not so sensible. But this movie just doesn't even pull it off, doesn't even come close. The writing is horrible. Like, some of the lines that are supposed to be hilarious, people told me, were terrible. Some offensive, that I mean, I obviously couldn't tell you what they are, but some are really offensive and not really that funny. Like, yes, the audience would laugh along, and from, you know, as an audience, you would typically laugh, but if you watch that kind of movie alone, you will not laugh, I promise you. Also, the pacing was terrible. I mean, at one point through the first 40 minutes or so, they're getting ready for the heist and everything, and then after that, it's about an hour, 40-minute long film, and after that, it's all of a sudden goes quick, 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 quick. I mean, even the heist itself really feels unsatisfying to watch. Also, again, I'm going negative again, plot holes. Plot holes everywhere. I'm not going to really mention any because I don't want to spoil anything, but there's, I mean, a love interest that makes absolutely no sense. There's a couple scenes that just really are pointless. I mean, it's just a bunch of really unnecessary plot holes. I'm not going to ruin them for you guys who want to go see the movie still. There's only one good thing I can think about this movie, Matthew Broderick, and he's a good actor. So this wasn't any surprise. Now, you might say, well, the writing then must have been good because he probably, delivered some funny lines. But his acting just sort of took those terrible lines and actually made them decently funny. And he was the main comedy entertainment to this film and was the only reason I could sit in there and not have to check my watch every 5 minutes to see when the movie's over. So overall, there is no question. On my channel, this is the worst movie I've reviewed on this channel so far. And I'm going to give it a lowly 3 out of 10. I mean, are you kidding me? Yes, I didn't go into this movie expecting an amazing movie, obviously. I thought it would be a decent comedy. You know, like you said, turn off your brain and everything. But even turning off my brain, there are just moments where you just sit there and you go, come on, is that really necessary? Did they really pull it off like that? Is that really their excuse? I'm sorry. This is the worst film on this channel I've reviewed this year, bar none. So remember to subscribe and check out my website, www.relentlessreviews.webs.com. So that's another show of Relentless Reviews. I'm your host, Joshua Englander. Do not go see this movie, but go check out my channel. We'll see you next time.